At the end of the topic, you will be able to explain the refraction through lenses, differentiate concave and convex lens, identify the important terms related to lens, analyze the formation of image in concave and convex lens. You must have seen different types of glasses, such as plain glasses or curved glasses. Have you seen objects through glasses? You will be amazed to know that the images formed by the curved glasses would be small or big or inverted and depends on the nature of the curve. A piece of curved glass is called lens. Let us discuss the refraction through lenses. Lens is a refracting medium with shaped pieces of glass or plastic with one or both sides smoothly curved. The different types of lenses are concave, plano-concave, concavo-convex, convex, plano-convex and convexo-concave. In this discussion, let us focus on the lenses which have identical surfaces and are very thin. They are convex lens and concave lens. Convex lens is thick in the middle and thin at the edges, whereas concave lens is thin at the middle and thick at the edges. Now, let us learn the important terminology used in the study of lenses. Central plane of the lens is known as the vertical axis. Optic center is the center point of the lens through which the emergent ray looks undeviated after refraction through the lens. The extension of curvature forms a sphere with a center called center of curvature, and the radius of the sphere is known as radius of curvature. The straight line passing through the center of curvature and optic center is called principal axis. When a beam of parallel rays is made to pass through a lens, it converges or appears to diverge at a point on the principal axis after refraction. This point is called principal focus. The distance between the optic center and the principal focus is called focal length, F. The distance between object and optic center is object distance, U. The distance between image and optic center is called image distance, V.
Let us see the refraction through convex lens. The image formed by convex lens either be enlarged or diminished depending on the object and lens distance. The focal length of convex lens can be determined if the object and the image distances are known. The reciprocal of focal length. This is called lens formula. This formula gives the relation between object distance U, image distance V, and the focal length F. The lens formula given above is general and is valid in all situations for any spherical lenses. The ray diagrams for the image formation in a convex lens for a few positions of the object are shown in the figure. When the object is at infinity, all the rays from the object are parallel when they strike the lens. The image formed is smaller than the object, real and inverted. When the object is beyond 2F1, the parallel ray from the object after refraction passes through the focus. Another ray passes undeviated. The two rays form an image between F2 and 2F2 on the other side. The image is real, inverted and smaller than the object. When the object is at 2F1, the image is formed at distance 2F from the optical center. The image is real and inverted and is of the same size of the object. When the object is between F and 2F, the image formed is magnified and is formed beyond 2F2 on the other side of the lens. When the object is at F, the refracted rays are parallel and they will meet at infinity. Thus, the image formed is real, inverted and magnified. When the object is between the optic center and the focus, the refracted rays diverge from each other. Therefore, when extending the rays backwards, they meet at the same side of the object, forming a virtual image of the object. The image formed is erect and magnified. Now we will look at the refraction through concave lens. We know that a parallel beam always diverges after refraction through concave lens. Hence, the image formed will always be virtual, erect, and cannot be caught on screen. When the object is placed at infinity, the image is at f1. The image appears to diverge from the focal point of the lens. The image formed will be virtual, erect, highly diminished, and is on the same side of the object. When the object is placed between infinity and optical center O of the lens, the image is formed between focus F1 and optical center O. The nature of image is virtual and erect, and the size is diminished.
The focal length of a lens used for correcting the vision is expressed as power of the lens. Power of lens is defined as the reciprocal of focal length. P is equal to 1 by f diopter. Its unit is diopter. 1 diopter is equal to the power of lens for the focal length of 1 meter. In this topic, you have learned lens is a refracting medium having a pair of combination of either both convex or concave surfaces. Convex lens is thick in the middle and thin at the edges. Concave lens is thin at the middle and thick at the edges.
The lens formula is expressed as